Hello and welcome by AA's Art Channel. My name is Ilkin Wiersma and today I'd like to share with you how I painted this fox painting using my acrylic paints and my airbrush. But before we do that, I finished this painting a few weeks ago. I'm a little behind schedule because I had another tutorial made only talking about the supplies, my top 10 oil painting supplies. That was last week. So if you missed that, I will have a card pop-up by now. You can check that out. I will talk about all the supplies that I like to use, like I said, for my oil paintings. I am planning to do a sort of the same tutorial about the acrylic painting supplies that I use, but that one will be up probably in January 2019, because in a few days, as you know, of course, we're gonna start a whole new year, and this will be my last tutorial for 2018. And also I will have a new tutorial on how I'm painting a portrait. I recently did finish that, but I don't have the tutorial up and running yet, so that will be also in January. And also I'm gonna start a few new projects and for 2019, and that will include a little bit more about how I use Photoshop and how I design my paintings before I start really painting them on a canvas my drawings on a paper. So I try to show you that process as well. So I'm very I'm looking forward to share that with you guys. I'm trying to find out how I can best film that, and I also, it's quite new for me, so I have to get a little bit more experience with that, but that is also coming in 2019. But like I said, today we're gonna focus on this painting. And I did adjust quite a lot about this painting. The original photo came from Pixabay, and I made it a lot darker. And also I included the fireflies. And I did that because I really want to get that feeling of a deep feeling in a forest. I really, really like that when you are deep in a forest. It's just... if you are deep enough in the forest, it's almost as if you are going into a whole different world. And I hope that I could basically grab some of that feeling and paint it on my canvas. So therefore I did change a lot, and I'm really happy with the how it came out. It's one of my favorites. And I think in real life it does show up much more, because it's very hard to get a good lighting on this painting. I think because of the airbrush, and of course I already furnished this, but I will have a photo, of course, in the end of this tutorial to give it a better to give you a better chance to look at it as how it appears in daylight. But for this one, I think because of the darkness and the airbrush, it's a little bit harder than usual. So, that said and done, now we're gonna start with the tutorial, and I see you back at the end of this video. Bye-bye. As usual, I start out with a background color, and most of the times I'm just filling up the whole canvas just to get rid of the white of the canvas. This green color is quite translucent, so it does show up lighter, especially the first layer, and I'm also leaving quite some brush strokes. That doesn't matter that much, because I need quite a lot of texture in the background. So I'm not going to do a great job on make it very smooth. I leave some brush strokes because I just can use them for the texture. And this, I'm filling in two layers, and then I'm blocking in my main subject, so I know where or which should go. And also it makes it easier when I'm airbrushing for example, trunks of trees in, I can better decide where those trees' trunks should go, because I now have a general idea what the main subject is focused, is placed, I should say, on the canvas. So what you see me doing here is painting in those textures, and now I know where which one should go. And also I'm not copying the reference exactly, I'm just filling in the basic shapes. And with the airbrush, it's quite easy. I think the hardest part of an airbrush is getting used to holding it and how you use it, and the cleaning process. The cleaning process of an airbrush is very important, because otherwise it's going to clog, and then
It can be very hard to get the paint get out right. If it's clogged, you get thicker thicker spots of paint on your canvas. So be aware of that. Keep your airbrush clean, and if you do that very good, if you do a good job on cleaning the airbrush, it works perfectly. And that takes a lot of time, and also the mixing of the colors takes a little bit more time because you have to clean up your airbrush in between different colors. But yeah, like I said, I'm just focused on the general shapes and also the different colors. I used, I think, at least 6 or 7 different greens here. A darker to a lighter, and I mix them, and I make different motions with my hand to create a more, texture, roughness, not texture that you can feel, but that you can see. And I just use my reference photo to get a general idea of that texture, and I try to copy it as closely as I can. But once again, I'm not completely focused on the exact colors or shapes, but I just want to have a general feel. And it's the same for this leaves who are in the front. I'm just picking up a brush, and I'm making a same motion over and over again, and I'm changing it a little bit, and that gives me the indication of those leaves. And I'm starting out with a very, very dark color, so I can paint a lighter color on top of that. That gives me the more the depth in the painting. So I always start out with quite a dark color and then building up. And that is for the in focus part, but for the background, I'm just like you saw, starting out with a quite solid color, so I get rid of that the white of the color. But when I'm painting in leaves and for this tree, I'm starting out quite dark and building up to the light. That is just a personal preference. You can do it. There are different ways to approach this look, but I like to paint from dark to light. And you see me here using quite often the unbleached titanium white. I like that color, and then I'm glazing over greens and purples to give it a more richer feeling. But the unbleached titanium white is very very nice to use for making textures, and it allows you to glaze quite easily, if you ask me. And if you use the unbleached titanium white in your colors, it doesn't change much of color. You just need more glazes, or your glazes are a little bit too thin. But that is from experience, you will get used to it, and you know how thick your layer should be. And yeah, you may need different layers. As you can see, I'm working reworking it quite a lot, and this tutorial is sped up even give the indication that I'm maybe not glazing as much as I really do. I think at least 8 to 10 glazes on only the tree to get those colors right. So don't think it's going very quickly, because it's like I said, it's sped up, so it may give a wrong indication there that I'm painting very quickly. That is not the case. I'm just taking my time. And once again, on the fox also, I'm starting with the darkest colors. I really found it very useful and handy to start out blocking in the darkest shadows, the darkest undertones, and build up from there, because the lighter colors will show up much easily. And once again, I'm using here the unbleached titanium white, and I will glaze over that, because like I said, the unbleached titanium white works very well with glazes, and it shows up better if your undertones are darker. Even though sometimes I'm starting out even darker than in my reference, but that is all because I'm gonna glaze, so I'm gonna tone those colors. Even the darker colors and the lighter colors will get some different colors over them, so I can lighten them up a little bit or make them darker. And I use the same color over sometimes over the darker parts and the lightest parts, and it will give you the feeling of it's one part. It's one part of fur, even though there are darker and lighter sections. But once again, the more you practice it, the more you get experience with it. With this, you will see and notice what will work and how it works. It's hard to explain. You really got to get to try it if you are interested in it. And the layering process of painting, it really suits me. I really like it, and it's it allows me to paint quite a lot of details, different shapes, using a lot of colors, which I like in my painting. I like to use as many colors as I can. Of course, they have to make sense, so I don't use a yellow where I need to use black, for example. I know that's it's a bit strange, but yeah, you get the idea. But I like to mix up quite a lot of different colors. And also be aware that white of his fur shows up very white, but it still is on bleached titanium white. It is not titanium white, that is the whitest white that I use for my paintings, but only for the highlights. And there are always, most of the times there are just a few very, very deep highlights where I use that titanium white. Like for that little dot on the nose, that is titanium white. And I think the little lines in his nostrils is also titanium white. But probably I mixed it in even with the unbleached titanium white. I'm not quite sure, but sometimes I do that. I mix in a little bit of titanium white with the unbleached titanium white to make it a little bit lighter, but not that hard hard light as you will get when you're only using that titanium white. And really spend your time on making those different shapes and different textures there. That will make the fur look realistic. If you do it too quickly, if you don't take the time, you will not get that really rich feeling of the fur, like you almost can touch it. And I try to accomplish that every time when I'm painting fur, that really that softness, and that I can only get that level of fur painting if I take my time and I rework it quite a lot. But I need the texture, and I work in clumps of fur. It's also very important. And like I said, take your time. It's very, very important. And once again, I'm starting out dark, and you can see how much it shows up when you start dark. It's really, really wonderful. And now, because I do that, because there is such a large contrast between the light and the dark in the first layers of the fur, I can use quite a lot of layers of different colors. And like I said, I like to use quite a lot of colors. So I also need quite a lot of layers, otherwise I cannot use all those colors. And that is why I paint in a big contrast, like you see me doing here, between the lights and the darks. And when I started painting, I thought the contrast was way too big. But as long as it is too big, even though we have a few layers in, that means you need more layers. It's just that simple. And when you get a hang of that, it works perfectly. And you see me here using once again different colors, and you see how it changes. It's getting more and more one piece. The fur is getting as one piece on a fox. It doesn't stand out as much as it did before, because I'm layering and I'm layering and I'm layering. And here I'm putting in a few highlights, because of all that layering you will lose your highlights or those fine lines. And most of the times at the end I'm painting in some individual hairs. But most of the times, like I said, I work in clumps of fur, but I paint those in later on. And when I have all the glazes in, of quite a lot, I'm painting those highlights in. And when they once again stand out a little bit too much, I just do a little bit of glazing again. And the more I paint, the further I get in this painting to the end, I glaze little sections. In the beginning, I glaze big sections, I glaze basically all that I painted in, but now I just focus on the different colors, and that means that my areas of my sections of glazing are getting smaller and smaller. And I really like to mix a little bit in of that yellow with the reddish orange color of the fox. And this is also, it wasn't in my reference photo, but I do that because at the end you will see me paint in those fireflies, and those have a light tint to it, a yellow, a light yellow tint to it. So that has to reflect on the fur of the fox, because otherwise it will not make sense. It will not be one piece. So therefore, I'm already painting in that yellow color because I know which color I'm going to use on those fireflies. So I'm glazing in that yellow color now, even though those fireflies aren't there yet, but I know where they are going. So therefore, I can glaze that color in, and it will make sense as soon as I paint in those fireflies. At this stage, it may look quite strange, because why would there be yellow in his fur? But that will make sense later on, like I said, because of the fireflies. And I'm sure that I make them a little bit yellower than they are showing up in nature. But we don't have fireflies here in the Netherlands, so I don't quite sure about that. But I like that contrast, because it's quite dark painting, because of we are deep in that forest, like I talked about in the intro. But yeah, and it's surrealistic, so I thought I can do a little bit more about the contrast in the painting. I just like that. And if you don't like it, you can stick more by the more natural colors. But I, once in a while, I like to focus on, to make it a little bit more brighter, the colors. And that was what I did with yellow, because I personally like green and yellow very much together in a painting. So therefore, I thought that I will, hype up that yellow a little bit more. As you can see here, this is a light green mixed in that yellow and that green, because also the light of the fireflies will reflect on the leaves. So therefore, I already start out with this highlight, and I just personally I really like them, how they stand out in that green. And that is one of the nicest things about art, maybe probably the one nicest thing for me, because you can change what you want, you can paint what you want. And there will always be people who aren't liking it, and they have always need to say it to you, and not in a nicer way, but they need only give a bad review because they like it. Don't let them get into you. Just paint what you like. It's so important. And I did it when I started painting, and I really took it personal. And now I try to get rid of that, because I just like this. I like to paint, and if there's somebody who isn't liking it, that's okay. And obviously, I like to make good paintings and nice paintings for many people, because that will help build my channel. But yeah, if you are focusing too much on what other people will like, I think you lose a little piece of yourself, and you never, never should do that. Just paint what you like or draw what you like. It's very important. And I like fireflies. I never painted fireflies, so here you see me do that, and I'm using the airbrush for that, and it works really great. You get that real soft appear of the light of the fireflies. And once again, I hope I did a good job on getting that dark, wonderful feeling of a deep forest. I hope you understand what I mean by that. Like I said, it's for me, it's just entering another world, and I really, really like it. There's something very, very beautiful about that, if you ask me. But this is the finished piece, and like I said, I tried to get as good as photo as I could, but this one I had a really hard time with, and that is because of the airbrush. The shine of the airbrush, because it's so smooth on that canvas, it was quite hard. Every little light on falling on the canvas was basically confusing my camera, but I think I did a good job. It's very close how it looks in daylight in real life.
So like I said in the intro, for this one I also did some Photoshop work, and including different colors and making different arrangements with the fireflies. And this was the for me the best arrangement. When I started, I had a little bit too many of them, so therefore it's very useful to design your paintings and drawings in Photoshop, if you ask me, of course. There are many ways to do that, but a lot of artists use sketchbooks and sketch their own things. I like to use Photoshop, but like I said as well in the intro, I need to learn much more about it. And like I said, I am planning on doing a whole tutorial on how I design my paintings with Photoshop. So that will be up in 2019, and I can't wait to film that, because In 2018, I was already working on my iPad Pro. I'm drawing and painting on an iPad. But as you may know, it's kind of hard to get it connected with a Windows PC. It's doable, but for me, I know basically nothing about computers. It can be quite hard to find out how you can do it. But I find a program that I needed to find because now it works perfect. So I can now finally film it and show it as well as to you guys and on my channel. So that will be up in 2019. And also I like to mention that I really like this golden frame. I think it works very well with those fireflies. Of course, it's a personal taste. If you, if there is a buyer, for example, and they like a brown frame or a black frame, it is also I can take it out of this frame and put it in that frame. But personally, I like the golden frame, and I found this frame in a secondhand shop, so I kept it, and now it did suit this painting. So now it's hanging like this in our living room. So for now, thank you for watching, and of course I wish you all the best for 2019. I hope you have a few wonderful holidays coming at you as well. And of course I hope you had a few already. And of course I'm talking about the Christmas. I hope you had a nice Christmas. And once again, thank you for supporting me on this channel. And like I said, I hope to have a quite and a lot nice of new tutorials for you in 2019, because I really enjoy making them, and especially when I have new subscribers. It's really and my old subscribers sticking with me, of course, but it's really encouraging me to that was kind of hard work for me, but to make more tutorials. So thank you for that. And for now, if you like, you can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and on my own website. And I hope to see you at one of my next tutorials. Bye bye!